I've got an Acom 2000, which is capable of doing actually more than 2000 watts, because it will do 2000 watts with about 500 watts of return power as well. So it'll compensate and give me like 2400 watts. There was a comment not so long ago, somebody said, why the hell do you want a 2000 watt amplifier? So for a start off, it's all about engineering sympathy. Okay, so if you've got a barking dog out here, if you've got a Fiat 500 and you're doing 100 miles an hour in it, it won't be very long until the con rods will come flying out the top of the engine. I have a 3-litre motor car, and generally the maximum speed I do is probably 70, 75 miles an hour. I think I've done maybe 90 once, I don't know. And I've got no idea what the top speed of it is. Might be 135. I just don't know, all right? The problem is with electronics, if you've got like an Acom 7300 and you do FT8, 15 seconds on, 15 seconds off, at 100 watts, I can guarantee it, because a couple of repair shop people have told me, you'll melt it, okay? It'll go, right? You will, the finals will just, you know, well, just get too hot. So why a 2000 watt amplifier? So let's go back a little bit, forgetting FT8 now. RTTY, RTTY, is a continuous duty mode. So if you did 35 seconds of RTTY at 400 watts, can you imagine the stress that's going on in the electronics with that? So I wouldn't want an amplifier that only did 400 watts. I'd be stressing the thing to the blooming limit. So give me an auto-tune amplifier. Why not? I'll have an Acom 2000 every time. Absolutely. If you're in the USA, yeah, they can do 1500 watts PEP on their voice peaks. Oh, that's fine as well. But I'm not in the USA. It just so happens I've got a commercial industrial license to cause QRM on the handbands doing my testing. But if I'm doing 400 or 500 watts, let's take feeder losses, 3 dB of feeder losses from on 10 meter band, and I'm gonna do RTTY, 400 watts RTTY, let's say, then I'm gonna have to do at least 800 watts key down RTTY for maybe 30, 40 seconds of, when it's my over. Just because you've read on EHAM and Facebook the general baloney of why people are buying some power amplifiers like that. One, they can. And two, why the hell do Ferraris still sell, and Mercedes and McLaren? So don't regurgitate baloney. It just makes you sound stupid, all right? That's the reason why I've got a high-powered amplifier, and I'm sure it's the reason why a lot of people that can afford it buy the same, all right? Because they just want the thing to last forever, frankly. They don't want to blow it up. That is a picture of an Acom 2000, by the way. That's it for me. Next video is coming up here. Jolly good day. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.